Now Jim Eisenreich moves into the game. He will play in left field and bat in the ninth position. Taking over on the mound, right-hander Ricky Botalico. Take over. You see his numbers right there. He will end up batting in the number four position, originally occupied by Pete Incaviglia. So Jim Fregosi with a double switch gets Eisenreich in the game in the ninth position. Botalico, normally the closer, hasn't had much to close recently, so he's going to get an inning's worth of work here and just try to hold this game close, give the Phillies a chance to try to do their deal against Jeff Brantley in the ninth inning.
Clark and Davis and Branson right left to face Ricky Botalico. Barry Larkin tonight, a perfect night, an infield hit, a walk, and he was hit by a pitch. Ricky Botalico's first pitch, a big swing and a miss by Larkin. Botalico, lifetime against Cincinnati, has a 1.08 earned run average in seven games, 8 1/3 innings, one earned run. He's been in two games against Cincinnati this year. Swing and a miss, trying to hold up on a breaking ball. Larkin does not look comfortable against Botalico.
There's a lot of people that don't look comfortable against Botalico, but Larkin, the type of hitter also you have to be careful with, because he can look real bad on one pitch and real good on the next one.
Another breaking ball. Yeah, he didn't like him. That's about as bad as you'll see Barry Larkin look with a couple swings. He was pulling off the whole time.
Yeah, it appears as if Larkin went to the plate with one idea. Just, I'm going to look fastball, fastball, fastball. Got three straight breaking balls from Botalico. And, you know, with Botalico's velocity, you have to get it started soon. Larkin just guessing wrong, looking inside half fastball, getting outside half breaking balls.
Even the good ones can look bad when a pitcher has breaking balls hard as Ricky Botalico throws it. Jeff Branson on deck. Willie Green batted in that spot. Hit grand slam home run in the first inning for the Reds, and they've made it hold up. It's 4-2 here in the eighth inning. Swing and a miss at a fastball. 1-1. And the balls and strikes are working again. Here's Botalico. You saw the numbers on him. As Teek mentioned, he hasn't had many save opportunities lately because the Phillies have been struggling so much. In fact, they have lost 13 consecutive road games to tie their club record, and in danger of setting a club record tonight if they can't come from behind in the ninth inning. Started out the season playing real well on the road. Swing and a miss blew him away with a fastball. Two up and two down on punch outs for Botalico here in the eighth inning, and that'll bring up Branson.
Botalico hasn't got a whole lot of work recently, and guys that throw as hard as Botalico, if they're that rested and can find the plate with the stuff that they've got, they're going to be really dominant. And he's right there with that high, hard fastball right in on Davis's hands. The only thing you worry about with Botalico when he gets too much rest is the control going to go? Because as we saw early in spring training, guys that throw hard have a tendency to have their mechanics get out of whack just a little bit easier. So that's why Jim Fregosi continues to try to find spots to get Botalico some work, even though they're not in safe situations.
Has a strained left hamstring, as Willie Green, on a day-to-day basis. Branson, a pretty good fill-in player for them. Breaking ball and a beauty over 1-2. Botalico has come into this game with great stuff, but unfortunately, the Phillies are behind. Bouncing up there, blocked by Lieberthal, 2-2. In the ninth inning for the Phillies, they will go with Lieberthal, Murray, Sefcik due to bat, and then Eisenreich would be the fourth hitter of the inning. He is batting in the nine hole. Two ball, two strikes, two outs, and nobody on base. Fouled off Lieberthal back to the screen. Reds open a series with the Cubs here on Friday. Phillies open a 10-game homestand with the Montreal Expos, who are very, very much looking like a wild card team in the National League East and a threat to the Braves in the division. If anybody can be considered a threat to the Atlanta Braves, look, they kind of just play with you.
That's what's scary about the Braves this year is, you know, notoriously they kind of flounder around the first half and then kick it in gear the second half. Can you imagine if they accelerate the next half?
Struck him out, struck out the side.